My name is Rachel. I am an ambassador animal specialist here at your Dallas Zoo. And today at the Wild Encounter stage, we have five-year-old Zena and her baby, four-month-old Salvador, with their trainers, Robin and Heather. Now here at the Wild Encounter stage, you can see these two. They are Tamandua's, but if you're looking at them, you might think that they look like a different animal that you might know of, like the anteater. And you wouldn't be wrong if you think anteater, because they're also known as lesser anteaters. Now, when we say lesser, we do not mean that we like them any less. Trust me, we love these two. They are pretty much adored here at the Wild Encounter stage. Lesser just means smaller. So in the zoo world, lesser is smaller. And if you think of the giant anteater, which you could see here at your Dallas Zoo in the north side, these are just smaller to them. So being an anteater, you might think obviously that they eat ants, but if you see them with their trainers right now, they are also eating some fleshy fruits. Out in nature, these guys are omnivores. So they eat plants and meat. And their plants for this time is gonna be fleshy fruits because they do not have any teeth in their mouth. So those fleshy fruits like avocados, oranges, bananas, plantains, go down really easily for these guys, along with those ants. They still have a very long tongue. It is 14 inches long. Now, if you're not sure quite how long that is, if you think of a giraffe, and you've ever fed the giraffes here at your Dallas Zoo, they have about an 18 inch long tongue. Now that's a 4 inch difference in tongue length with a huge difference in body size. Zena and Salvador are not even the size of a giraffe's head, and they still have about the same tongue length. Other than their tongue being a really cool adaptation that they have those front claws, and these things are super powerful. If these guys wanted to, they can pop a car tire with ease, but don't worry, they're not going around popping people's car tires. Those claws help them climb around in the trees because this species is arboreal. So they live up in the trees. Those claws help pull the bark off the trees to get down to those ants and termites, while also helping them climb around. Now, along with those claws to help climb around, they have a prehensile tail. Now, a prehensile tail just means that it's a grasping or grabbing tail. So they're able to hold on with their tails and hang from it as well. So say their foot were to slip in the trees, they can hang on with their tail, or if they needed to get down low to those ants and termites, they can use that tail as well. Now, these guys may look like they're super soft and cuddly, but trust me, they are not. That hair is thick and coarse and grows in a crisscross pattern. Because if you've ever stepped in an anthill before, you'll realize really fast how not fun that is. Those ants will swarm all over and they can bite and it stings and it's not so fun. So that crisscross hair helps protect the tamandua from those ants getting down to the skin, and it kind of traps them in and it's hard for those ants to get out. So remember, I said 14 inch long tongue. Ready? Just go on back, grab it off your own body if you're a tamandua and slurp it up for that to-go snack. Now, along with having that crisscross fur, if you can imagine putting your face in an anthill, it'd be very uncomfortable. So not only will they close their eyes when they're face first into an ant site, but they can close their ears and their nose with little flaps of skin. So those ants can't get into those sensitive areas of a tamandua. That black and white coloration is something that we might be able to spot here in Texas. No, it's not gonna be tamanduas, but we have the skunk with a similar black and white striping pattern. Now, out in nature, black and white is like a stop sign. It's a warning saying, stay back, you don't wanna mess with me. And just like the skunk, the tamandua smells really bad. So don't worry, they cannot spray that smell if you're visiting here at the Wild Encounter stage. That scent stays with them, just like their sweat just constantly stinks, like that musky, skunky smell. Now, this is a defense for the tamandua, because if you ever smelt your milk before you drank it to make sure it was good and you wouldn't get sick, same with some predators. If your prey smells really bad, you might not want to eat that because you can become really sick as a predator. So being really stinky helps protect the tamandua. But not every predator has a great sense of smell. Harpy eagles found in Central and South America along with the tamandua do not have a great sense of smell. So that's when those claws, like I mentioned earlier, come back into play. If they can pop a car tire, they can easily do some damage to the face of a predator, the wing of a predator, and do a lot of damage to protect themselves. They'll raise those claws into the air and swipe down to be able to grab, pinch, or poke their predators. These guys eat up to 10,000 ants a day. If you can imagine eating 10,000 of anything, I can't even imagine. Grains of rice, maybe that's like 2 cups of uncooked rice. But 10,000 ants a day, if they ate all 10,000 ants from one ant site, they would wipe away that population. So what a commando ant does, which is really amazing that I think humans can learn from, is that they eat a little bit from one site, eat a little bit from another, and then they'll have a set route that they'll go. And by the time they come back a few days later to that original ant site, the populations have replenished and they can keep hitting the same ant sites without having to go out and finding a whole different one. Humans kind of go through an area, we take out all the natural resources and don't let it replenish. We can learn something from the tamandua. Now, we don't have tamanduas here in Texas, but we do have a lot of arboreal species. So ways that we can create a better world for tamanduas and other arboreal species, ones that live up in the trees, is making sure that we are recycling paper when we're done using it. I know some of us are going back to school or we're maybe doing online school, but either way, if we're using paper to solve our homework problems, making sure that we're using both sides of that piece of paper. Same with coloring. And adults, I wish I could tell you to go billless, but I just can't. I haven't figured it out yet. But we can go paperless on our bills and receipts and have it emailed to us instead. So that's the way that we can reduce the amount of paper that we are using. Another big thing that's been hitting tamanduas out in Central and South America is deforestation due to cattle farms. So they're raising cattle out in there, they're clean cutting the land so they can have more cattle. So I'm not telling you to go vegetarian, I know I'm not, or vegan, but if we can all just cut back on the amount of meat we're using or looking up and making sure our meat is coming locally, that's a great way that we can help out a lot of animals out in nature. Because if we all just did a little bit, it would create a big effect worldwide. Now, if you guys wanna come and see Zena and her baby Salvador, make sure you come by to the Wild Encounters stage to say hello. We're gonna be out here every hour on the half hour from 9:30 to 3:30. So I'd love to see your smiling faces underneath those masks. I know you're still smiling underneath there. And I would love to see you come by here at your Dallas Zoo.